As you saw there, I was playing a little bit ETS2 and you gain decent frame rates, but yet there is still like stuttering or juddering. So what I'm going to do now is show you how to fix that. Right, so we're going to launch your truck simulator 2. It doesn't matter, ideally you want to be running it in 64-bit if you have 64-bit Windows. Just they have optimized it a little bit more over the original 32-bit version. So right, so now that you're in the game, you have the game loaded up, go to options, graphics, and this is where we're gonna do the main changes. Okay, so first of all, don't copy my settings because I can run it unless you have the same sort of set up of, or higher than I do, then obviously go for it. Because I have a 3240 i3 running at 3.4 gigahertz, 16 gigas of RAM, Nvidia GTX 970. So I can run the game quite high. Right, so if you're running that sort of system, then this is going to help alleviate some of the stuttering. If you're running lower end spec machines or even higher spec and you're getting stuttering, this should help too. Right, so the first thing you want to do is click disable on the VSync or vertical synchronization, and then that's it for the moment. So what you want to do now is alt tab out of the game. You want to go to the Nvidia control panel just by right clicking the desktop and go control panel, then navigate to manage 3D settings and then go to program settings and select Euro Truck. If it's not in your drop down, click add, then click highlight it because you click it and then add, and that will add it to the list. There's only two settings that you need to change, and that is vertical sync. What we want to do is turn it to on so that the hardware is, or well, Nvidia software hardware is controlling the VSync rather than the game, and then turn on triple buffering. Now for ATI cards, it's definitely called something buffering. I will have to check on that. The setting in the ATI Crimson software catalyst, whichever I'm guessing, I don't use ATI cards anymore. The setting is open GL triple buffer. That's the setting to on the ATI cards to help. So you can enable it, disable it if it helps. If it doesn't, that's the best thing to do. But for Nvidia cards, these are the two that you want to modify. All right, so we can close that out. Now that we're back in the game, we're gonna check our options just to show you that it's still set to disabled. One thing you can also do is set the refresh rate to default. For me, I normally had it set to 60, but for some reason this helps alleviate some of the load. It just does for some reason. So that can also help if you're on low end systems. So let's go to drive, because I'm running an i3 3.4 gigahertz, and yeah, I'm seeing vast improvements over, you know, how it was, and they've updated the game to a point where it's running great, but I know for myself and a lot of people that get stuttering, and this just solves it. I know that it works with the ATI cards. I did get a friend to check it out. He said he was getting great improvement over what it was. It was running a lot smoother. That's all I can say, really. It's to enable the VSync on for the hardware to do the VSync instead of the software to do the VSync. That's basically what's happening. And then, yeah, so you should see smoother performance. Like before, I think I was getting between 30 and 50-ish FPS. Now I'm getting like 40 to 60. You might not see that improvement, that much improvement, but at least it'll be smooth. And that's what I'm hoping for. So thanks for watching.